that a young lady will choose to play the Ekwe as a career and not to be a doctor, an economist, or even a makeup artist?
It's a long story how I got here, but it's a very interesting one. I have always loved to fly. Obviously, as a human being, I wasn't born with wings. So my creativity, my imagination helps me fly. I went to St. Saviour's Primary School, and there on my yearbook, I wrote it that I'm going to be an economist and an entertainer. And somewhere along the line, I became who I am today. I started learning from scratch. All this started early 2014. I started learning everything from scratch. I saw a drummer. He just came in with a drum. He was holding the Ekwe drum. I didn't even know what it was called then. So I was like, what's this? And he was like, then my name, I was just going by Anu. That's my Yoruba name. And like, oh, it's Ekwe drum, it's from your side. It's like the Eastern talking drum, if I can put it like that. And I'm like, really? And I just, and I liked it. Later on, the owner of my establishment came and he just saw it. And he saw me just tapping it. I was clueless. And I was like, Anu, from today, you're going to be rehearsing this drum. You're going to play it. And show me what you can do in the next 1 month. My friends at first were worried, to be sincere. They were worried because they just thought it was too much. They knew I was just starting the music. They knew I was taking lessons. I was doing everything. They were worried because, I mean, you have to take care of yourself. They were thinking, would this be lucrative? Would you have enough money to get that new phone and do your hair and all that? But then again, I don't know. I think I'm just blessed to have supportive people. At first, I didn't tell my dad, to be honest. At first, I didn't tell him because he's the typical Igbo man. My daughter will be a doctor. At first, I didn't tell him. After a couple of months, I mentioned it to him. And he was very proud. He was very proud because I had already gotten some level of headway. I had already started rehearsals. I had already started singing, of course. I was singing earlier already. So he was proud. Anyone that comes to the house, he will give them my CD. This is a new song. This is a new song. Everyone is happy with what I'm doing. But it wasn't easy to convince other people. It was easy to convince my family because they trust me, they believe in me. A major challenge in music is the fact that nobody's going to love you just because they know your story. Nobody's going to want to appreciate you just because, oh, she's a fine girl, no. Or, oh, I know her, she's trying, no, let's give her a chance, no. If you're not good enough, if you don't cut it, they're not interested. So, being that I just started learning how to play about 4 years ago, I am put on the same platform to showcase myself with drummers, male drummers, that have been playing all their life. So what helped me get here? My creativity. Most times, traditional drums come with traditional music. And I'm not going to be playing the Ekwe all through the hip-hop song. Just put it in there. Own it. Okay, this is hip-hop with an extra. Okay, this is Afro-pop with an extra. Once in a while, in the middle of a performance, when I'm performing live, I move to a different segment where I just play the drum. And I try not to make it as cliche as it has always been, with the traditional songs and costumes. No. What we wear to do the hip-hop is what we wear to do the dance, when we're dancing, when I'm playing the drum. So, you know, I just try to do it my own way. One of my best performances so far will be, I did an opening for the president and some people in Cote d'Ivoire, where I played the national anthem, the Ivorian national anthem. It was really nice. It was Sita 2014, when I had just started. So you can imagine how happy I was. I have cried so many times. I have been frustrated because my wrists were stiff. They're just breaking. They're just getting loose right now. My wrists were super stiff. I didn't grow up playing the drum. I've fallen on stage before. Listen, if you're a performer, you've not fallen on stage, get ready. Because one day you'll fall. But when you fall, stand up with swag. Just stand up and act like it was a dance. I fell and I rose. I kept rolling and I stood up and I posed. More than 2,000 people and they were clapping. So all them are posing. He started doing the pose with me and I'm like, man, I couldn't even believe I just fell. But it happened. It was, I didn't even, funny enough, I didn't cry, but my two of my backup singers were crying. They didn't like it. Oh my days. This has been worth every minute of my time. And I wouldn't change it for anything.